The boys finished our chicken run system today, or at least the ones that I've got for right now. So we are going to kind of do a before and after video for you to show how the chickens do with weeding the garden. So I'll show you what it looks like now, and then I'll show you what it looks like, I don't know, in a week or so. All right. Okay, in our garden right now, the worst spot is right here on the edge of the garden. So I'm gonna put the run all along here. You can see there's plenty of weeds to eat. Some of these big ones like that, they may not take all the way down, but they'll at least kind of strip the leaves and make them pretty sickly looking. The small ones, they should eat and, you know, get rid of those pretty much entirely. So this is our kind of before video. You can see plenty of weeds. All right, and we should have enough to pretty much make it to the end of this row right here. Okay, we'll set it up. Okay, we've got them all set up now. They go pretty much to the end of that row, which is great. Yeah, about a foot that they didn't. One other side benefit to this, that the way we have it set up right now, this isn't why we did it necessarily, but it'll be nice for this time of year. As you might be able to see, the deer have started eating the tops off of some of our corn, but they're mostly a little too nervous to get in close to the house, so they're just getting the stuff right along the edge. So this goes all the way along the edge right here, and then the tunnel goes along the edge here. Honestly, they can probably still reach in there if they want to. What I'm nervous about is, like on this one, the tassel is just starting to come up, and if they eat all of that, then there's nothing to pollinate when the silk comes out on these things. Which should start to happen in the next week or so. And if there's nothing to pollinate the silk, then we don't get any corn. So I'm gonna have to kind of keep an eye on it. If they keep eating these tassels off the edge, I'm either gonna have to find a way to make sure they get pollinated from some of the inner row stuff, or I'm gonna have to put a fence up out here, like a temporary fence, just to make sure they quit eating all the tassels off of my corn. So anyways, we're gonna kind of keep an eye on that. Hopefully this little tunnel makes them nervous enough that they maybe won't want to come around a whole lot. But that's the tunnel. We're excited that we've finally got it done. The boys did good work today. Okay, we've got the chickens back in there now. While we were working on it, we let them out to kind of free range out here and catch grasshoppers for us. We get lots of grasshoppers in the alfalfa field, so let them in there. Anyways, so in this new section where we've got them, you can see there's a lot of alfalfa and other weeds and stuff right up here next to the garden. So this is kind of a very thin run, or narrow run, that we've got them in for right now, because we wanted this to be narrow so that they'll focus on eating up these weeds and plants right next to the garden, and then also to push them into the tunnel more. So anyways, we'll check back in a week and let you know how we did. Okay, so we just finished moving the cages over off of the spot where they have been for the last about a week and a half. Maybe, I don't know, it might be close to 2 weeks now. I got busy and didn't get around to moving it as soon as I thought I would. But no harm done. The chickens just did an even better job fertilizing and tilling up my dirt here and getting rid of the weeds. So I'll show you how it is. Okay, so this is down here at the end. As you can see, we slid it over. This is where the chickens had been. Right here is just outside where the chicken run was. So you can see, you know, there's weeds outside where the run was. Here's kind of the little skeleton of what was a weed. Some of the bigger ones, they don't get the, you know, the full thing because of the vine or the stalk of it is too thick, so they don't go after it, but they sure stripped all the leaves off of it. And look at how well they've done scratching it up and keeping other weeds from growing in the area where the run has been. There's another piece of, I don't know, maybe alfalfa or something that they didn't get the whole stalk, but they got all the leaves off of it. There's some alfalfa that they've stripped the leaves off of, but haven't gotten the rest. Didn't get all of that, but they got all the leaves off of it. This right here, I don't know, I think it must have just fallen off when we were moving because it's not attached to anything. It's just some alfalfa leaves. Anyways, look how well they till all that up. There's some manure in there. It, you know, their manure gets all worked into the dirt. Just looks great. There's some stuff that was outside the tunnel. That's kind of what it looked like before. But you can see how they've stripped the leaves off of that. That wasn't inside the tunnel, that was outside the tunnel, and they were reaching through and scratching it up. So here's kind of the run that comes from the coop to the tunnel. And it used to be pretty thick alfalfa, like outside the run there, but they've chewed it all up. Just looks like a bunch of dead leafless alfalfa now for the most part. They really did do a nice job even in here. So as you can see, this chicken tunnel really works well for the chickens getting in there and weeding around in the garden. More than just weeding the garden, it's also great for people who are out in the country a little bit more and need some protection from predators. As you've seen in some of our videos, we have owls that live here, we have eagles that come by sometimes, we have hawks, we've even had raccoons that we've seen in the middle of the day kind of cruising around right here in the yard. So they're not scared of coming in here, but inside these IBC cage chicken tunnels, these are sturdy and they really do a great job of keeping these chickens safe. So in my opinion, these really are the best chicken tunnels that I've seen anywhere when you make them like this. I've looked at tons on YouTube, I've looked at a ton on Pinterest and on the internet in other places, and I have never seen any that I think are better than this. These are solid, they're easy to move, they come in, they're short sections based on how tall those IBC tote cages are. It's like 3.5 feet each section, so they're not heavy. They're really, in my opinion, ideal for this type of application to make a chicken run. And it was out of free material, so you can't beat that. All right, well, hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you next time. I'll keep making updates on this as we go along.